All right, the stage is yours.
Okay, thank you, Alexander. we are welcoming now Gabriel Galezo and Nicolas Auchet from the URFIST. They are very in high demand, so I really thank them for their participation to the workshop today. And the idea is to talk about open science courses, online courses, in relation with the European project Doranum. And also maybe to have some input from the European project Oberhead for the data management skills and open badges. So Nicolas, Gabriel, the floor is yours.
Okay, thank you. I'm gonna try to, is it possible for me to share my screen?
Yes, it should be possible.
Okay.
Yes, it's possible, yes.
Yeah, okay. Just 1 minute, please. Try to. Just one moment.
Yep. Maybe in the meantime you can present yourself a bit, Gabriel and Nicolas.
Technical problem. Just vas-y, Gabriel, just une seconde, dis qui tu es.
I'm Gabriel Galezo, senior lecturer in communication at the USA, UCA, we arrive at the UCA, and with Nicolas, we work in URFIST. We said in French, unité régionale de formation à l'information scientifique et technique. Voilà, je te laisse te
présenter. Mm-hmm. Okay, and it's okay for the PowerPoint. So I'm Nicolas Auchet. I'm the co-responsible with Gabriel from the URFIST, and I'll try to show you what is exactly the URFIST, but in English. Okay, is it okay? Can you see my screen?
Yes, it works well.
Okay, nice. So. This is the URFIST. I propose that we try to present you quickly what is your office, what is our mission, and what is our public, and after that we can discuss and present exactly our activity for open science and our European activities. So the mission of the office is to train in the practice of digital information, and we are attached to the local documentation services of the university. We have a regional mission for the PACA, Marseille, Nice, Corte, and Toulon, but also a national mission. The URFIST is a national network in France. There is a 7 URFIST in France, and we work in network because all the students are able to follow the courses from all the URFIST in France. So the name of the network, it's not very interesting for you, all this information. We are a very small team. We are Gabriel and I, and usually we work with one or two pedagogical engineers to help us to build the interactive presentation or courses or that we propose to our students. And we have also an help from the local administrative service. Alors, our public, we have three type of publics, the teachers and the researchers, also the students, the doctoral students, and the staff of libraries and documentation center. And in a larger explanation, we allow all the people under the responsibility of the Ministry of National Education to follow our courses. So our mission. So our first mission is to train our public in face-to-face or distance learning. We have also a mission of design and training, and sorry, to design and deliver training for trainers, for teachers, students, monitors, etc. So we prepare, advise, support training and research needs. We also design and produce multimedia and educational tools for trainers and users. And we have an expertise in the field of information and communication technologies, digital documents, and in particular in electronic publication. Alors, here are some examples of our training session on mission that we propose should in face-to-face or for distantial access. The classic biometrics courses, Zotero for the bibliographic solution. Also, some courses on how to create your websites. And sure, as Gabriel proposed, open science introduction, science matrix or bibliometric matrix. You can see all the examples that we propose. How to submit your publication in Open Archive, NAL, corporate practice for researcher, the use and the law on image in research work. And so publishing in open access, what consequences for the researcher? That's just an example of the type of training that we propose. In order to manage these courses, description, registration for the students, certificate, support, statistic, emailing, all around the training session, we use specific tools, online tools. The name is CG4. It's a web application that we have created. So we are using CG4. This is a free software, and it's a creation from the Urfist network that helps us to anim all around our system of training courses. These tools is free and can be downloaded and used free of charge if you are interested by it. I can try to show you two screen caps. Yes. So there is a front office and a back office for us. On the front office, the public can see all our courses from the national network, and if allowed, they can access to this sessions. Another, so it's the first way to find our courses. The second way for the, we have just created something very new, because these tools at the beginning is 20 years old now. So at this time, the courses was only face to face. But now with the digitalization and with the online courses, we need a new tools to work. So we have created a new platform on with the Callisto project. The Callisto project is a mutualized national platform for open training. All the courses on this platform are free for our public. Free to use, free to follow, and free to reuse. If you're interested, you can access to the, I will give you the link to this to platforms. Accepted the courses. We have also in our mission mission of expertise on research on different projects. For example, and that's in this context that we work especially on the European projects. I will try to show you later the different projects and what we are working on. Yes, some examples. Actually, we are working on three main projects around the context of open badges. Yes, you can show it. I don't know if you know exactly what open badges are or if you use it, but in the Urfist network, we are using it to certify attendance at internship, to recognize the skills, to formalize these skills, and to guarantee the refill. That's very important to guarantee and to follow the refresh of the knowledge. That's why our open badges are chronodegradables. And we are also working on reference framework. Yeah. We are trying to work on framework, especially for open science, in another project. So we have actually three open badge projects: an internal in Office Méditerranée that help us to create a tutorial and use the open badge as if you follow courses, you will receive an open badge. But it's not very interesting in this context, because this kind of open badge are just here to say, okay, I was here at this moment, or I follow these courses, but it's not very interesting. That's why we prefer to use open badge in two other projects, a GIS project. So the GIS in French, it's a scientific.
Institutional group project about scientific project.
Yeah, through open badge. And also an Erasmus Plus project. The name of the project is OBRED. OBRED is a project with six European universities. And the idea of OBRED is to create an ecosystem between open science skills and open badges. the idea is to recognize the open science competencies with open badges. So for example, if you need in your laboratory, if you want to know and to organize the competencies of your different the different person of the team, you can use open badge to formalize your needs and your internal skills.
Sorry to interrupt you. Would you like to have the comment during your presentation or at the end of your presentation? Because I see there is some comment in the chat.
I have a problem with my skin, so that's why
we don't see the chat.
Okay.
Maria, could you please read the questions?
Yes, I will read the questions.
But it's okay. I have the questions. Okay.
Tell me more about badges. Okay.
Please tell more open badges. Okay. And what is the link to the GIS project of open badges? Okay. An open badge is it's a digital image with metadata inside. So the most simple example of open badges is, for example, if you came and follow courses that we propose in the office, at the end of the courses, you generally have an evaluation or something like that. And if you succeed that, or just if you are here till the end, you will receive an open badge that certifies that you were here and that you follow these courses or this study journey, or it depends. But the aim of open badge is more to recognize non-academic skills. In your life, you can have a lot of skills that are not academic. And the idea is to help people to recognize this kind of skills. And we use it, we are using it in the Obred project to recognize the open science, the open, not open science, the skill of the open skills data of research. Open data research, yes. The problem is that actually there is no, to do that, to recognize skills, you need a framework. So the first job that we have to do in this project is to build a framework of skills, of
competencies,
of skills.
It's like a skills classification.
Yes, skill classification and detail about skill and how we deliver badges about the different competencies in this framework.
We can try to give you what is a skill for us in open science.
Peut-être qu'on peut montrer un exemple du référentiel.
Ouais, mais il est en français.
Non, il est en anglais.
I'm trying to I can try to show you an example of the framework.
Je l'ai
sur le web, mais le réseau il marche à deux à l'heure. We have network problem.
Je reviens.
this. I'm sorry, we have a problem with the network of the university. So as the document is online, it's very difficult to access. So no problem.
Ça va venir. C'est long, mais ça va venir.
C'est very slow.
Ça y est. Je vais partager.
T'es dans le meeting?
Oui, je viens de rejoindre.
Ah, ok, ok, ok. Voilà,
parce que
je vais always share screen directly because ok. Ok. So this is the
this is a framework about Obrecht project and for example this column A present the life cycle data and we have some donc the first step about the cycle life cycle data is planning design. The second one is a data storage description and format. The third one, data quality and curation. Next one is analyze data and data processing, archiving, and publication, publish and release. This is the first column presents donc it's about this life cycle data. And the first level, the badgeable level, okay. We name the L level, decline this the first column to data topology and processing mode, opening data, etc., etc. And
this one is good. You can use the third one. I can use a DMP, for example.
Okay.
Next one.
Just on the
right. Yeah, this is a good example. So, for example, if you know what is a DMP, you will receive badges structuring and design the data management plan. So, to do that, you are supposed to know. That's why we propose. I know what a DMP is for, and to control that and to deliver the badge, we propose, because it's just a proposition, that the laboratory or the university that wants to deliver this badge creates a quiz with different proposals. We're not at the beginning, but we have not finished this framework. That's why for the moment we have not finished it, but we propose later we will propose an example quiz for all this for all skill for each skill. We will try to propose a way to evaluate the skill,
and we try to connect this framework we have made to especially for this project to a framework of ESCO. We recognize a generalized skill in Europe. Okay, but maybe you can talk about this after our presentation.
Okay, sure. Yeah, I will talk about the European skills.
For us, the problem is the skills in ESCO are too large for us to recognize open data, open science specific skills.
On peut peut-être, je te laisse repartager la présentation.
It is interesting to see actually all the skills that you identify in relation with open access data management.
For the moment, we have identified I think 34 or 35 level of
first level
first level
first level of skill. Mm-hmm.
The starting point of this this framework was the data life cycle, and for each element there is a five or six steps in the data life cycle. So for each step we have between two and five skills in for each step of the data life cycle.
And this framework should be modified by everyone to match with the local situation. For example, if you are a data librarian, or you are a researcher about informatics or chemics or biology, you need to adapt this framework to your situation.
And more than that, you must adapt this framework to your local legislation. Because the rules are different in each country, so it's not possible for us to propose something to static. The framework should be able to be adapted for each local situation or legislation. Is there any question?
Il y a quelqu'un qui a trouvé le promo bread, mais c'est pas ça. Mais je vais mettre les liens.
Oh yeah, the link that you have put in the chat, it's not the website of the project of the. Of the bread project but it is interesting too, because we have produced three MOOCs for around this project, and these MOOCs are on this platform here, the open MOOCs that you we have produced three MOOCs. The first MOOC was on open badges, to know what is an open badge or does it work. The second was on the data research sharing, what are these data. And the last one was, how can I do if I want to recognize these skills with open badges?
And we have also a question from Alexander saying, is there an automated way to find all the badges of a certain person?
Yes or no. Yes or no. When you receive the badge, you have a lot of solution to use and to present this badge. You can imagine to put this badge on your websites, on your LinkedIn profile, you have also the possibility to print it, because it could be a PDF. But the best way, the best practice to use open badge is to have an open badge passport. I can try to show you what an open badge passport is.
I would like to just ask meanwhile, so is it the individual responsibility of a user to create this open badge passport, or it is issued by somebody? What is the procedure of getting it?
You can have your own personal passport, but you can also have an institutional passport. For example, we have a passport for the Your Feast, and we have a passport for us, for Gabriel, for me, and for the other.
Okay, thank you. Do you know at the UCA level? I will just turn on my camera. Sorry. At UCA level, is there at least an initiative to have a UCA passport? Maybe regrouping different types of open badges or not.
I'm sorry.
UCA, we start to work on something also, but not on, okay. Directly in the field of open science. And we are counting on the office to develop the badges also at UCA related to open science.
Okay, thank you.
Okay.
What institution recognizes badge in the Europe?
At the beginning, open badges were produced by the Mozilla Foundation, were proposed by the Mozilla Foundation. And now there is a lot of open and not open of pay solution. The passport I show you is open badge passport. It's the free and open solution. You can also use Badger, for example, which is an open solution, but there is a lot of other platform to use and collect your open badge, and also to deliver with this platform, with Open Badge Passport, you can receive and store your badges, but you can also deliver badges, simple badges, sure, but you can deliver badges. And I will answer to the initial question. Regarding the if it's possible to see the people who have received a badge, I'll show you my personal passport. Okay, so here you can see different badge that I received. Okay, and. It's interesting because if I use this badge, for example, okay, this badge was just to I was just present and I contribute to a National Day 2 years ago. It's my choice to choose if I want that this badge be private or public. I can choose. When I receive the badge, if I want to keep it just for me, or if I want to show and share the badge with the public. And
there is the option for the community of the Open Passport on the platform, and the option for public, like even outside of the platform, right? When you share the badge.
When you share the badge, sorry, I don't understand. When you share the badge, what is
it? I was checking for just what you show us before. There is the option of privacy, like privately, or you can share it with the community of the platform, or you
Absolutely. Should totally private, or with the platform community, or with the general public.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And for each badge, for example, for this badge, I can see that there is 24 people who received and accept to share the information, this badge. And I can, and if they allowed it, I can click on this person and you're able to know. So for each badge, that's a good way to show you what is a badge. You can see an image and the metadata. The metadata are, okay, who delivered the badge, when, during how long this badge is accepted by the person who delivered it. And you can also, everything is in French, I'm sorry, for this badge, so it's not very... but I think that you can use this platform I can translate in the platform English, Finnish, maybe it's better if I show you the platform in English. This is the place where I collect the badge I receive. For example, this one is printing. I received this badge, but as you can see, the badge is now expired. So that means that if I want to, I must follow a new courses to have it again. And finally, just one thing, at home, as I said, I can, on this platform, I can collect my badges, and I can also create and issue badges, because yes, so it's a very, if you compare it to a pay platform, it's a very simple tools, but it permits to create a very simple badge and to deliver it.
Il y a deux autres questions.
Mm-hmm.
What institution recognizes badge in your...
Alors, if you want to have more information about the badges, there is a European world, not only European, a world platform to... Comment dire recenser. Okay. Where you can find all the institutions interesting and who use the badges. But for example, the Napoli University use badges for a lot of courses. In France, I know a lot of local. Of local institution who use badges. It's not in the university context, but a lot of local institution as big cities or use it to help people who are looking for a job. To show and to summarize their non-academic skills.
Et une autre question, is it possible to fake an achievement
and
receive a badge?
No. You can create a badge, but and create and deliver. You can yourself. I can create a badge and deliver the badge to myself. It's possible, but the good thing with badge is that you can verify and check the badges. The value of a badge is. The badge has absolutely no value. The only value that has a badge is the value that the person who deliver it or the person will recognize it.
Endorsed.
The term is endorsed. For example, we have created courses on specific tools on the internet. Okay. And the person who follows this course with us on the success the evaluation receive a badge. But so the value of this badge is recognized by the URFIS, the person who delivered the badge. But we have decided, we receive a proposition from the editor, from the editor, from the publisher of this website and application solution. And he said, okay, your courses is very interesting, it's very valuable, and we all agree to endorse. To validate the badges that you deliver. So that's to explain you that the value of the badge is in the badge by the person who deliver it and who validates it. And you can always check a badge. In the metadata of the badge, you should have a proof. The proof is a link to a website or a document to download. Or in a badge, you have a proof. If you don't have this proof, there is the badge has absolutely no value or is fake. IBM also used badges in his internal programs to help the people in the company IBM to learn certain skills.
Une autre question. Is there a way to use your platform to add some custom badge, like badge?
Sure.
Absolutely. Yes. For the Obred project, we don't use this platform. We use Badger. I can show you Badger. No, Badger. So Badger is native in English. I can show you. This is the Badger page on the website. I spoke before about the three MOOCs. If you follow and succeed the MOOC, you receive the badge. We use this platform Badger to deliver these badges. Okay. The first MOOC was Open Badges for Open Science Foundation level. Okay. This is the badge that we have created and delivered to the person who follow and succeed the MOOC with the earning criteria. You can also use the badge as a step. For example, I think about that because I see this badge and you can see a star. It's possible to imagine to build the courses with different steps, and for each step you receive a star, and that means that at the end of the complete courses you receive a global badge, which is constituted by three small badges. It's possible to do that, to create to create travel and in the evolution of your skills.
We have a question from Alexander. I remember that the Foster project also had badges. Is your approach similar or more advanced?
Similar. Similar, yeah.
And about the endorsement, is there any institutions that are endorsing your badges, or is it only the Orfist, for example?
No. The endorser could be anyone, because the I try to find an example.
For example, if I produce some badges about Zotero courses, URFIS could deliver badges to the participant of courses. But if Zotero Foundation endorse my badges, then all participants have badges, have a great value about this badge.
Yeah, so what gives the value to the badge is also really important. It's the endorsement.
Yes.
Yeah, sure.
The delivery. So in the case of Optima project, for example, maybe what we could imagine, if we develop a skills classification related to the open courses, they could be endorsed by the different partners of Optima project.
Yes.
And this will give more credibility to the badges.
Yes, sure.
For example, for Obred, the badges will be the badges for the open the Obred badges will be endorsed by all the partners, by all the university involved in the project.
Okay, I see.
In concretely, that means that if you present on your CV, you present a badge that recognizes your competencies in open science, the proof of your badge is endorsed by six universities who recognize that
competencies,
the competencies is real and that the framework is serious.
Okay. More questions? Ah, tu as partagé le. Yes.
J'ai partagé Badian. Ouais. On va peut-être revenir à la présentation parce qu'il est là, on n'a plus.
Oh, sorry. I come back to the.
Pour repartager.
To the. Yes.
Ah, bon, que ce soit déjà.
Non, c'est pas partagé. I come back to the PowerPoint. Another important project that we are working on it is the Doranum project. The problem is Doranum is only in French, no?
Doranum is only in French, but it's a platform who present e-learning course about research data sharing. And there's many tutorial video or PDF or image or animate information. And you have a link and you have to show some, but it's in French.
Yeah, the problem is that in French. In the, tu veux que je le montre?
Non, c'est non. Pas la peine, non. On ira voir. Ok,
Doran, you have the. Yes, you have, this is the, here is the logo on the.
On peut le montrer, remarque, allez, montre, on va le montrer.
Non, attends, je vais faire ça. Doranum. Because it's in French, but there is a lot of graphics and. I'm going to share my screen. Doranum, where are you? Doranum.
You have some resources here, and you have some item to. Je vais montrer par exemple le premier en jeu bénéfice. En jeu bénéfice.
En jeu bénéfice. This one. Okay.
So. You have some.
Tu veux
j'arrive vraiment pas. Je suis pas habitué à ça.
Yeah, for each item, you have a quick presentation, and usually you have a short video who presents the solution.
Yeah, and you can use it.
Oui, on va couper le son.
On va couper le son. You can use it. You can download it. Yeah. And
j'ai cliqué sur. Yes, all these resources are free and open. You can choose to if in French. You can download, evaluate, share. You can do what you want with this content. Back to the.
On va passer à un autre.
Okay. So I saw that you have like different thematics for the courses. Yes. Like research integrity, ethics, introduction to open science, data management.
Yeah,
it's really a wide range of courses related to open science. And also you develop courses and study cases, if I remember well, for the different disciplines of research, like specifically to if it's biology, specific study cases for the different disciplines.
Disciplinary Doranum.
This is the extension of Doranum, and this is a disciplinary Doranum, and but it is a project, and it start next month.
Yeah, but there is already some content. I saw it on Doranum for different disciplines, like for economics, I saw it, for ecology.
Yes.
What else? We have also a project for labeled PhD training for open science.
It's a project for e-learning in for PhD students in University of Strasbourg and next years to UCA, and we choose some student. We have different discipline, and this student. Aurélien, est-ce que tu peux m'aider vu que tu as participé au projet?
Oui. So the project is about training doctoral candidates, PhD students, for around 30 hours, I think. It's to train them about open science, more especially about open access data management, and also to train them to teach the same training to other PhD students, so they will learn how to train their peer, the other PhD students. And the idea is to have around 10 doctoral candidates for the first program from different disciplines. So it will cover the disciplines of the university. And then they will be able, each of them, to train around 10 or more other PhD students from the same field. And the idea is to recognize this training by validating some hours of training in their program, and also to pay them for the courses they will give to the other PhD students. And so in this case, it's the ERFIS that are that have the budget to fund this project. And the interesting point is really to train the PhD students, then they will train the other PhD students. And we really think that it's the important, because they are the next researchers, and they really need to be aware of the in open science. So I don't know, Gabriel, if you want to complete, or if someone have a question about this program.
It's perfect. Thank you.
And finally, the last point on what we do for the open science. It was a survey about open data. We conduct a survey about research data in different institutions to have a snapshot and of practice, different practices to understand the needs of the researchers with open data, open science, and to understand or to understand, to see the
how the researcher practice
and
use information and
in the
share data.
It's finished.
Yes.
Yes. And the conclusion?
Do you have some question? I feel this project material is viable online. Not already.
Will it be available in the future? Yeah.
Yes. In Callisto.
Okay. And it will be like also French content, or at some point there will be some translation in English.
First in French, and at the end maybe in English or other language.
Mm-hmm. Yes. For Obred is the only project in all in full in English.
but maybe can you
but
the other maybe yeah. partner could translate
the local
Okay, thanks a lot for your presentation. I don't know if we have some other questions from the audience related to the different projects. We can discuss a bit how we could adapt it or how what we could take from that for to develop an Optima project. Yeah, Alexander, I see you have.
Yes, actually, you mentioned the HAL archive, as far as I remember, right? So that is a French National Archive. Is it open? Could you please tell us more, a little bit around about this?
About HAL?
About HAL, the French National Archive?
It's a yes, it's a French archive we have found by State of France and with a CNRS institution, INRIA institution. I don't know how many euros it costs, but it's free for researcher to share a publication in HAL. In France, we have a law named the Loi de pour une République numérique, and it's where when you publish in a journal, if you give copyright to the publisher and or not, you should share your publication to upload your paper in HAL.
You have some exception, sure, but yeah. but the common law is to publish in HAL. The PhD candidates also have to upload their thesis in the archive. Yeah, we saw that.
Not this archive, but like this. His name of this archive is TEL, thèse en ligne. Je vais trouver là.
In French, there is also a project to have a national repository.
Data repository.
Yeah, the project is to build a national data repository.
I give you the link in the chat to PhD thesis to archive of PhD thesis. And next year we have a data repository. It completes HAL. In HAL, you deposit or upload a paper, publication, article about journal or congress or something like that. And in a data repository, you upload data about this publication, about your publication. So we have two archives, one for publication and one for data.
And the access is not only national. You can have a local access to the global to the global server. Each university has its own trail.
And I have another question, because in Optima project, we think about how to update the courses with new subject on open science. And so did you already work on that, like to try to update some courses, some new subject on open science?
Maybe. If it's in English, It may be difficult for me, but if you want, you can use a bread MOOC. You can use Doranum. You can use FLSO on Callisto. You can use every item of this on this platform. But more of this item, more of this information or tutorial is in French. But maybe we can help you to translate something, or you can help me to translate something.
Okay, Irina is asking, what's the link to Callisto project?
The link is in the chat.
Je l'ai pas. Ah, yeah. Je l'ai mis que pour. Pourtant, je l'ai mis.
Que... Non, Callisto Formation. This one. 14h58.
Ah oui, je l'ai mis en haut. Ouais. Mais je le remets. Il est juste. Ouais. Non, c'est pas celui-là.
Pas celui-là.
Elle est là. Je le remets.
Callisto.
Ouais. Bah voilà, tu l'as fait.
But in Callisto, the courses are in French. There is no English courses.
Actually, all the courses in French. Mm-hmm.
Okay. And Alexander, is it one of the goal of Optima project to develop a skills classification that will be developed through the different open courses that will be developed from Optima?
Actually, not perhaps a skills classification, but what we would definitely like to do is to somehow structure the competences around open science and let's say, think about a balanced approach to our courses. So let's say PhD students, PhD candidates receive a balanced vision of what is open science and practices they will be able to use, right? So if there is an approach which already exists, it would be definitely interesting to have a look at it.
Mm. Yeah, because you can use the framework to build your courses. So it's a good way to identify the skills.
Yes, we had a comment from Irina saying it would be great if you could share the skills spreadsheet with us when ready, the one you showed.
Of course, but we need to finish.
Yes.
She said once it will be finished.
No. The for the moment, the project is not finished. The project will be finished at the end of July, but I think that the framework should be ready in April.
But this framework, it's about only on research data, research data only.
Not on open science.
Only on research data. We have no open access framework, for example. Mm-hmm.
But there is some maybe other skills classification that we can find on internet.
Foster classification, and maybe you can see ESCO classification. EOS classification.
Yes, because ESCO is not enough.
EOSC
is very interesting because you have an approach by skills, you have an approach by jobs, you have an approach by activities, and it's very helpful to build courses.
Okay.
I'll try to find you a link to
EOSC.
C'est pas ça.
Non.
Yep. In the meantime, maybe I'm curious to have some input about what do you think about the use of open badges, maybe from the different partners, if they have some idea about the idea to use open badges for Optima project, maybe, or.
Actually, we alongside the general courses in Ukrainian universities, we will also develop an open online course, a MOOC, actually, right? in Ukrainian. And I think that there will be different smaller courses, right? So perhaps open badges is a very nice approach to recognize people who pass the courses, right? So yeah, and that is why I was asking if it's possible to use your existing platform to somehow host our badges, or should we deliver our own, develop our own approach?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so maybe the use of Badger platform could be interesting in this case.
Yeah, yeah. I think the best platform for you is to use the Badger, yeah. Okay, Gabriel, put the link to EOSC, the EOSC European project in the chat. So you have no more questions?
One second. Шановні колеги, можливо, в когось є запитання українською мовою, я міг би їх перекласти нашим колегам. Можливо, комусь буде простіше говорити українською, я міг би перекласти ваші питання. Будь ласка. I'm just asking if there are perhaps questions in Ukrainian easier for people to communicate. So.
Yeah, sure. You understand, we do the same thing in French.
Пане Богдане, я можу долучитися?
Будь ласка, прошу, пані Ольго. Так, звичайно.
Я щиро дякую за можливість сьогодні взяти участь в такій цікавій зустрічі, дуже цікавий цінний досвід. Я хотіла назватися, my name is Ольга Петрова, I am doctor of public administration, I am head of department of research activity of Institute of Higher Education of National Academy of Education Science of Ukraine, and we in our department have a topic for research open science, and we have finished the first phase of this research, and I think that partnership with a project with your project is very interesting for our work and for project maybe too. Тобто я дуже дякую за таку можливість. Насправді сьогодні дуже цікаві доповіді про відкриті бейджі, про відкриті системи даних. Я думаю, що це такий конкретний досвід, який є надзвичайно цінним для українських наших вітчизняних вузів, і, звичайно, для дослідників також дуже цінним є цей досвід. Щиро дякую за
це. Ольга, дуже дякую. Можливо, у вас ви маєте якісь запитання до наших доповідачів?
Насправді, поки більше приводів для того, аби все обміркувати, я записала всі посилання і, звичайно, з цікавістю вивчу цей досвід, поділюся з своїми колегами і використаю його в наших дослідженнях.
Дуже дякую. Дякую.
Насправді, я хочу зараз просто, якщо ви дозволите, скинути посилання на коротенький опис нашого дослідження.
Можете просто в чат надсилати.
Так, я зараз посилання скину і буду, там, правда, анотація є англійською і українською. Таким чином, я сподіваюся, що сьогоднішня наша зустріч, вона буде тільки початком співпраці. Ще раз щиро всім дякую.
Дякуємо дуже. Okay, so dear colleagues, there is a link to our colleagues Olga Petrova's research. I think that it's an preprint, right, of the preliminary part of the research, which is made in Ukraine on open science. So there is also an abstract in English, so everyone interested could, of course, read this. Okay, many thanks for your input, Olga, and looking forward to see you tomorrow with our webinars, of course. Okay, dear colleagues, perhaps there are any other questions, comments? Because we have this really unique opportunity to communicate today with our French colleagues who are experts in open science and of course open badges. And I think that open badges is a very nice thing because it brings gamification approach to education, and this is also very important because people are immediately recognized. People pass something and they get something. It's touchable, it's very tangible, and this is of course important for students, PhD candidates, and early career researchers, because when young people receive something right, they are perhaps more used for some things related to social media, like likes, shares, and everything. And open badges might give them not, of course, the same functionality, but something very similar. And from my point of view, it's a very friendly way to recognize people and their skills. So, okay, any questions, dear colleagues? So thanks for recommending the badger. Perhaps you really have a look at this and implement this open badges system in our own courses. And is it possible to have another perhaps short consultation with you while we are ready to proceed? Perhaps in a half year, in a year, once we are ready, okay? Sure. Okay, okay. Many thanks for your presentation. And
you're welcome, thank you. Many thanks to you.
Hope we will be able to communicate in future. Would you mind if we share this video on YouTube channel of our project? I mean, the recorded video. Okay, yes. So more people are able to watch and learn more about the open pages ecosystem. Okay, Rhea, any comments from your side?
No more comments. Thanks a lot for your participation. It was a very interesting. And I think there is a lot of link to make with Optima project.
Exactly. I will, of course, save the chat, and chat will be available in Optima Project MS Teams environment, so anyone could access this. So thanks again for all of you for participation. I will now stop the recording.